When a low frequency signal wave is superimposed on a high frequency carrier wave, the process is called modulation. Something in the carrier wave should change when the signal wave is superimposed on it. Some characteristic, some parameter of the carrier wave should change.
If the carrier wave is a continuous wave, it could have been a pulse, then either its amplitude can be altered, or its frequency, or its phase, and correspondingly the modulation will be called amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, or phase modulation. The carrier wave could have been a pulse. Note that the communication system gets the name from the signal used. If an analog signal has been used, it's called analog communication system. Whereas the modulation gets its name from the characteristic which has been changed. So if amplitude has been changed, we call it amplitude modulation, which we are going to study in detail now. Let us consider a continuous carrier wave of amplitude say 5 and frequency something. Now this 30 appears to be too higher, so I'll change it to 20 so that you see something on the screen, say it's visible. You can change this amplitude, or rather what I'll do is I'll substitute some variable here which you can vary continuously. Say minimum value is 0, maximum let's say 5, and steps let's say 0.1. So now when you vary this value of A, the amplitude has become 5 now, which you can see somewhere here, and now the amplitude is, say, it varies from 0 to 5. Let us now introduce a signal wave such that it modifies the amplitude of the carrier wave. If I add 3 to A, then A being 5, the amplitude becomes 8. You can see it here, this is 5, this is 10, 9, 8. But if this 3 varies with the time as, then something interesting happens. The value of this part varies between plus 3 and minus 3. Now, A being 5, the value of this entire amplitude varies between 5 plus 3, 8, 2, 5, minus 3, 2. Now, you can see this thing here. When this 3 sin t has value 3, the amplitude is 8. You see this part, 10, 9, 8. When this part, 3 sin t, has value minus 3, then the amplitude is 5 minus 3, 2. This is 5, 4, 3, 2. What you see on the screen is an amplitude modulated wave which has been generated when a signal of low frequency is superimposed on a carrier wave of high frequency such that the signal wave modulates the amplitude of the carrier wave. We can replace the value 3 with the variable B. Now, as you vary B from 0 to 3, you see the varying amount of modulation happening. And accordingly, we define a term called modulation index. Right now, when B is 3 and A is 5, the modulation is 60%.